Trump's 60 Minutes interview, or you know what passed for an interview, finally came out. And we're gonna talk about a few parts of it. The first is that he once again implied that his healthcare plan, it's coming, it's coming.
You promised that there was gonna be a new health package, a healthcare plan.
Yeah.
You said that it was gonna be great. You said it's ready, it's gonna be ready. It'll be here in 2 weeks. It's gonna be like nothing you've ever seen before. And of course, we haven't seen it. So why didn't you develop a health plan?
It is developed, it is fully developed. It's going to be announced very soon when we see what happens with Obamacare.
If the Supreme Court ends this Obamacare.
Well, we're gonna have to see what happens. I think, I hope that they end it. It'll be so good if they end it.
And if they end it, people with pre-existing conditions will be stranded.
No, no.
And that's just a fact.
It's wrong. It's wrong. A new plan will happen.
But will.
And we won't do anything, will and is. We won't do anything and no plan unless we have pre-existing conditions covered.
Okay, so it's coming. It's very soon. It's fully developed. Can I see one page of it? Maybe half a page? No, nope. You can never ever see even a line of it. But it's fully developed. It's big. It's beautiful. Francesca, I feel reassured. You know what? No matter what happens at the Supreme Court, it's ready to go. Apparently.
Yeah. No. Yeah. The monkey. That's in the third briefcase that the monkey's got. It's just the healthcare.
His tail's holding it.
And we're like, can we see? No, ooh, have a banana. You know, we're like, no, we don't want a banana. We just had a banana. Ooh-ee. Okay, okay, we'll take the drugs. We'll take the steroids. Thank you. What about the healthcare plan? Ooh-ooh. You know, there's a lot of.
Hey, monkey, why does that briefcase looks really light? I don't think anything's in that briefcase, monkey. No, ooh, no, it's here.
we can do this for an hour, John. I would do this. Straight up for an hour. Don't like, man, in come January, I just want to do that. The entire show in a monkey voice. No, obviously, it's not coming. It's nowhere. And yet consistently, and this is what's so incredible about this Hindenburg of a campaign strategy, is like watching it self-immolate is incredible. Like it is, you just one thing, do one thing right. You know, I've always said that Trump is like the worst villain, because like even a villain, you're like kind of hoping wins. Like you don't want Lex Luthor to like, you know, slip on a banana peel. You know, like that's just corny. You don't want him to be that bad of a villain. But Trump can't even mess up right. And this healthcare plan is a perfect example of that. And the fact that Americans are consistently voting when around healthcare. And you saw 2018, Democrats take back Congress in the wake of a lot of protests about healthcare. And you know, news broke, we've done a whole piece on this, is that actually when social programs are enacted, they're incredibly hard to take back, right? And the ACA is not Social Security, it's not Medicare, it's not Medicaid. It is actually a giant handout to private corporations, which is ironic because it means that Republicans can't find a way to make even more money for private health insurance. They can't find a way to make it even more pro-business, this ACA, right? And so, but of course they're not gonna help people. Of course they're not gonna introduce a public option. You know, heaven forbid, of course they're not gonna, you know. So they're stuck between this rock and a hard place of a fairly conservative social program. And the fact that none of them believe in actually helping Americans.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's actually popular. 55% of Americans do support the ACA, as flawed as it might be. So it's beautiful to just watch them flounder, you know? And again, you know, completely botch this.
Yeah. Yeah, 100%. I want to add only one thing. I apologize. I don't remember who on YouTube said it, but someone reminded me, you know, in terms of his plan, and we've been talking about who we think has the plan, you know, a tiny little briefcase and a tiny little monkey. About a week or two ago, the White House was touting this declaration supporting a herd immunity strategy that had been signed by a bunch of doctors, but people looking into it began to grow a little bit suspicious at some of the names on the list, which didn't seem like real names. And do you know what one of the names was? Dr. Johnny Bananas. I'm not saying anything. I think we found our monkey.
For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.